Bye. Let's continue that on. Well, well, well. Hallelujah. Isn't the Lord good? Hallelujah. I know you hear that all the time, but it's the truth, isn't it? Isn't the Lord good? Hallelujah. Isn't the Lord good? Hallelujah. I've been redeemed tonight. Have you? I've been washed in the blood of Jesus. Oh, by the blood of the Lamb. I've been redeemed tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. I appreciate that we could stand here tonight. And I thought as we was coming across the, I didn't know I was going to get up, but I thought as we were coming across, I said, you know, we're not going to church tonight to talk about the sadness of the world. No. We could get together and talk about the sadness of the world. We didn't come here tonight to talk about depression of the world. We didn't come here tonight to discuss life's problems. We come here tonight to get the answer to life's problems. We didn't come here tonight to discuss the problems of the world. We come here to see the problem solver tonight. I'm so thankful when they said unto me, let us go unto the house of the Lord. Aren't you glad when they said, let us go into the house of the Lord? I know I was. I appreciate God for what he's done in this place the last two services. There's life been put into our soul the last two services. If you don't, if you didn't get anything, what does that brother say that Brother Monty says all the time? If you didn't get nothing, your wood's wet. How does he say that? Brother, your wood's wet. I can promise you that right now, because there was life that came across his pulpit to our souls the last 2 days. God poured life into us. You don't find that just everywhere. You don't go to the street corner and every church corner and find the word of God that came across this pulpit to go into your life to give you life for your soul. People say, I need answers to my problems. The man of God gave it to you the last two nights.
Amen.
You say, I don't know what to do with my circumstance. The man of God give you the answer to your circumstance.
Amen.
The last two nights.
Amen.
I appreciate the messages. See, I just wanted to welcome the people. I just wanted to welcome everybody. I just love that. I appreciate the Lord tonight, don't you? Man, I'm so thankful for the miracles that God is performing. I'm thankful for the Spirit of God that we feel. I'm thankful for the presence of God that we feel. I'm thankful that we're not in a dead place tonight. I'm thankful that we have life here tonight. You didn't come to the Bradenton Gospel Tabernacle funeral home tonight. You came to the Bradenton Gospel Tabernacle where there's life for your soul. You don't find a dead person here tonight. You don't find anybody that's not alive. You find something that's real. You find something that has substance. You have found something that can change your circumstance tonight. You have found an answer to your life's problems tonight. You have found an answer to your circumstance. I begin to think about the circumstances in the Bible that God turned for good. Think about Moses. Was he standing at the Red Sea? God took a piece of wood and turned it into a serpent. He changed the circumstance around. He took the same piece of wood and spoke to the Red Sea and it parted. And people walked across dry shod. He took the same piece of wood and spoke the rock and water came out of it. I'm talking about a God that spoke to Samson with a jawbone of an ass and defeated 1,000 Philistines. That said he couldn't be done. But God gave him the grace and changed the circumstance. You want your circumstance changed around tonight? You can have your circumstance changed around. It's an honor to have you in our church tonight. I haven't personally met you, but you've got some lovely family. This girl here is a lovely daughter. We hope when you leave here tonight that you have received life for your soul. We don't want you to go out of here coming here depressed more than you came in. We want you to go out of here with something that is implanted in your life. Where Jesus Christ has changed you around, and leaving you longing for more and more and more. That's what kind of God that I serve. The circumstances He can change when He wants to, how He wants to. That's the God that I serve. I'm not telling you about a God that just showed up yesterday. This God has been here yesterday, today, and forever. He's been here before time. He's been here before you and I. He changed circumstances before your circumstance even evolved. He knew the answer to your circumstance. He knows the answer to your destiny. It all depends on what you want tonight. It all depends on what you need to get out of where you're at tonight.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
This is not a fake God that we're serving. It's not a part-time God that shows up when God decides that he knows exactly what he's doing, when he's doing it, how he's going to do it.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
He'll turn circumstances around for his glory, not for our glory.
Amen.
He'll speak his glory. Don't worry about what the enemy's coming against you. Don't worry about what the enemy's bringing against you. Just know that the Lord said, resist the devil and he'll flee from you tonight. All you have to do is tell the enemy to flee from your circumstance tonight. If you want healing in your body, it's here tonight. You don't have to wait until the end of this service. You don't have to wait until a man of God makes an altar call. If you desire for your circumstance to be changed, just like any other circumstance. Brother Zonneveld touched me last night when he began to talk about the upper room. Brother, it was a life changer. It was a direction changer. It was a circumstance changer. We want something different from God tonight. We can reach out and get an upper room experience and leave out of here healed in Jesus' name. I'm going to move out of the way, but I just want you to know that if you have a circumstance in your life tonight, you can let God change your circumstance.
Right. Amen.
You can be in whatever situation that you're in.
Amen.
Amen. God didn't bring you here by accident, brothers and sisters. God led you this way by choice. God knew that you needed something different in your life. God knew that He would bring you here today to change your circumstance around. I don't know where you came. I didn't know nothing. I don't even know you was here until you slid in that side door and boom, here you were. And all we can do is wrap our arms around you and tell you how much we love you. That's all I know to do. Brother, I'm telling you that tonight you can be healed. I believe that tonight you can get out of that situation that you're in. I believe my pastor. When a man of God preaches, I'm going to start believing it, Brother Richard. I'm not going to sit there and wait for the next moment. If he preaches it, I'm going to start believing it. He said it, God said, settles it. If the man of God preaches it and it comes from God, we better start believing it. Don't wait on it. Don't murmur on it. Don't think upon it. Move upon it, brothers and sisters. God is ready and restoring His church today. He's restoring you. If you need restoration in your life, He's restoring you.
Glory to God.
Amen.
I'll say this and move.
Amen.
Look, I was reading a book this week. You did this, by the way. You told me to get up here, and I didn't want to. I was reading a book this week about, you know that guy's, some of you read those books, but I love to go back and read about healing. I love healing. I love to see people get healed from depression, from sickness, from finances, from whatever their circumstance is. I love to see it. Because when someone is locked up and they're bound up and then all of a sudden they become free, it excites me. It lets me know that something is alive and well and that somebody can go and be a part. Somebody can get out of the situation that they're in. That's why I like to see someone healed. I was reading this story Some of you may have read it, but I'm going to tell it again. I was reading a story about Smith Wigglesworth. This guy was crazy. He told the man with no legs, he said, go buy you a pair of shoes.
Would you say that again?
He told him, the man had no legs. They didn't have prosthetic legs back then. And he told the man, he said, go to the shoe store tomorrow morning. I was just going to go quick, but this is how he said it. Get in, go to your shoe store, tell the man you want a size 9 shoe, and you want them in black.
And he had no feet.
And he had no feet. He had no legs. He went to the shoe store. A man waited on the man to open the door at the shoe store. See if the church could get back to the faith that this man preached. What more can we have from God? You want to talk about a restored church? You want to talk about a church on fire? You want to talk about changing lives? People running through that door. This man went to the door, waited on the shoe store owner to open up. The shoe store owner up said, how can I help you today? The man said, I'm here to buy some shoes. He said, I can't help you. He said, what do you mean you can't help me? He said, I'm here to buy some shoes. I need a pair of 9s in black. The man said, okay. He went and got the man a pair of shoes. From the time he got to the back of the store to the front of the store where that man was sitting, that man began to put his shoes on. You mean to tell me that God can't take a situation and circumstance and turn it around? You mean to tell me that God can't change your circumstance? Yes, he can change your circumstance. I about jumped out of my chair in my living room. I didn't want my wife to think I'd gone completely crazy. So I read down a little farther. And this man, I said, God, give me the faith that you gave this man. In between all of that, here's what happened. This was happening yesterday. I read these stories. In between all of that, Josh comes into church this morning. I'm going to tell you how it happened. I know you may not want, the devil don't want to hear it, but it's okay. Because I'm going to resist the devil when he's going to get on out of here. How's that sound? I'm going to resist the devil when he's going to go out of here. We had a wonderful service. I ain't getting into all of that. But the Lord began to speak to me. And the pastor said, we need to start listening to the Lord more. That's what the man of God said. We need to start listening to God more. The Holy Spirit come upon us, said, if you'll sit down here on that altar bench, we're going to lay the hands of faith on you. We begin to lay the hands of faith. His shoe was so swollen that he couldn't even tie it together. From the time we left the altar bench to the time I got back to my chair, his foot was down. He was standing on his foot. I heard the bones in his foot begin to go back to the place. The swelling was down. The man said, I can walk. The man said, I can move. The man began to shake his foot and jump up and down to where he cried. See, that's the kind of faith that we've got to have, church. You need a healing from God. It's here tonight. You want to get out of that circumstance? It's here tonight. Last story, and I'll move. His foot was broke. He didn't tell me what fell on it. He just said it hurt. And I think it's broke. Because I can't walk on it. And it was this big around. And we set up the church every Sunday, break it down. And he was hurting. So I began to read this story again yesterday, the second story. This man was sick. And he invited Smith into his home. And he said, pray for me. And he said, I'm not praying for you.
That's right.
He said, I'm not praying for you.
The
man went and laid in his bed that night and began to sweat in his bed. He got up the next morning. The man said, or wife, whoever it was, he said, look, I'm leaving. Get in the bed. Go lay where I laid last night. And that the woman went and laid in the bed where he laid last night. And the very anointing sweat that fell from the man of God, when that woman laid in the bed, she had eventually healed from a miracle of God, because a man of God believed and sweat in the bed in the great anointing. The same thing that he said last night, the anointing that flowed, the alabaster box that was broke, The oil that flowed out of the alabaster box is in this place tonight. Jesus is in this place. You want out of that chair? You can get out of that chair. You want out of that situation? You can get out of that situation. You want out of that circumstance? You can get out of that circumstance. You just got to believe God enough and say, I've had enough. I'm done enough. I need to move from the current situation that I'm in and reach for the next situation. That's how I believe.
Amen.
That's
Jesus, I hear you.
That's how I see it too.
I hear you.
I just fixed to say that. My cartoon character says that's how I see it. I believe in Jesus Christ. I better stay here. I believe that there's power in this place tonight. Look, after a man of God, after the Holy Ghost pours his word out to you and I, and we have ate what we have ate the last two nights, and then we don't get a miraculous service from Jesus Christ, something is wrong with us today. We need a move of God, church. We need an anointing of God in this place tonight. If you're ready for your circumstance to change, it can change tonight. Look, I'm not making an altar call. It's not my time to do that. But I'm telling you, don't sit there this night before that door is open and you leave out of here with your current situation. It's your own fault, because you have got a chance to get what God brought you here to get. Because your circumstance can change in this place tonight. Don't you believe that? I do believe that. If the church would move from where it's at to where it's going to be, how much greater we would be. I'll tell you this. Think about it. Jesus walked by a fig tree. He blessed it one time, didn't he? Said give it all that it needed. But it didn't produce. Come back the second time, and what'd he do to it? So he cursed it. Tonight, if your circumstances, God has given you the chance to get rid of, to move into your circumstance and move from one to two, don't let him come by the next time and say, forget about it. Get what God has for you tonight. Get what God has brought you here to get. However you need to get it, the Spirit of God is here. We want to make you welcome tonight. We want to say thank you for letting her be a part of us. She's such a lovely daughter. She's such a lovely friend to us. We thank you for being here. We want you to be blessed before you leave this place tonight. We want the anointing to be upon you before you leave here tonight. God bless you. We love you so much. Church, don't we love them? Let's give them a hand clap for being here. Hallelujah. Many places they could have went tonight, but they chose to be with us. And we thank you for that. Brother Marlowe didn't tell his company was coming. So we were ready, weren't we? So we need to be ready for company. We appreciate the Lord. Hallelujah. Going to move out of the way. Let the Lord continue to move here. I'm not going to say I'm going to move out of his way. I'm going to let him continue to move.
All right.
Because he's in this place tonight. The water is troubled here tonight. It was troubled when we came in the door. After the man of God preached like he's preached, the water has been troubled here tonight. You can get what you need from God. If you choose to leave here with your circumstance, it's your fault. Now, here's what our next phase is before we go into the greatest phase of it all. We are going to collect an offering. We're going to take an offering tonight.
Praise.
You say, I've given all I can give. No, you haven't.
No, I haven't.
Some of you can give double what you've given this weekend. Some of you can give triple what you've given this weekend. You say, well, I don't. Well, where's your trust in Jesus Christ? Where's your faith in Jesus Christ? Where, you say, I don't know if I'm going to be able to pay the light bill. This just sang a song about didn't he show up when the bills were due? If that's the case and that song was a lie, let's throw the song in the garbage. But it's not a lie. Because it showed up right on time. So let's bless the Lord with double our offering tonight. Mom, let's write a check. Double our offering. Let's write a good check. Double our offering. Some of you aren't busy digging. Some of you are busy looking. It's here or in your pocket. So dig deep. Grab what God has for you. Let him bless you tonight. Let him anoint you. Keep on casting your bread upon the water. And soon it's going to come back to you, isn't it? Are we ready, Ben? Play something, do something. She can write and play all at the same time. She's good. Amen. Come on, let's worship God as you're getting your offering up. Hallelujah. Come on, let's worship Him as you're getting your offering ready. Hallelujah. You can write and shout too, can't you? Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I wonder where's Brother Mike here, man. Where's his foot?
Back there, back door. Back door. Back
at the door.
Brother Michael, come on and sing my song. Praise God. I've been to Calvary. Oh, thank you, Lord. You know that message that Brother Matthew Knopp preached tonight is a message that can change your life. Because we're the church and we have many things that we have our God, but we live in a world around us that has its problems. Sometimes those problems evade our house because we are still mortal on this earth. But I believe what he said. God can change your circumstances.
Yes, he can.
Absolutely.
For Mike sings, I'll just say this. And you've heard it over and over and over and over and over and over again from this man. But every word is true. Every word is true. Nothing fabricated about the story. When I was 12 years old, I was homeless.
Come on, Pastor, please.
I came from a broken home at the age of 7.
Yes.
I lived in foster homes, in and out of foster homes, different set of parents, different set of people, till I was approaching 10, and my father took me back to his house briefly. And I ran away and joined the street gang. And right here in the streets of this city, where I drive down and see homes I used to break in as a 12-year-old, rob and steal.
Yes.
On my way to a prison, sleeping in boxcars under the bridges, sleeping wherever I could, back of donut shops, but there was nothing anybody could do to change me. The juvenile authorities chased me through the woods. They locked me up, and I would get out again from juvenile custody. Go back and go to it again. But one time, the city of Bradenton police arrested me, put me in the jail of the courthouse.
Yes.
In a place called the bullpen. There, a prisoner would have taken my life,
come on, Pastor.
But God delivered me.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And at the age of 12, my father arranged a plea bargain to get me out of there. But the sheriff of this county said, we'll let you out, but you are the meanest, most onerous kid I have ever met in my life. And he said, you will not live in this county. You are incorrigible. And they put me on a bus and shipped me 500 miles north to live with a relative I didn't even know. And I rebelled.
Yes.
And got off that bus in Port St. Joe, Florida. And I hitchhiked back. And I said, I don't know where I'm going, but I'm going somewhere. I can't live like this. And I walked down Manatee Avenue here, and my father, my biological father, was in a little mission church. It happened to be this church. When we didn't have this beautiful sanctuary.
Amen.
We didn't have all we had. It was a 20 by 40 hole in the wall.
Yes.
They called it the hole in the wall.
My. Dear God.
And when I walked in that building, what everybody else failed to do, in one moment, you're a gospel preacher. Jesus Christ. Changed my life forever.
Amen.
71 years ago, that happened. I have never looked back. That night, I had a home to go to, a nice home. I had a foster father who loved me till I was out of high school and loved me till he died. I had respect. I had people that loved me. I became known as the bully preacher.
Yeah.
And found myself in a tent preaching the gospel. Isn't God good?
Yeah.
Didn't this man of God say God is good?
Yeah. Yeah.
So your circumstances can be what they are tonight. I never saw my mother for 44 years.
Oh God.
That isn't heaven calling, that's myself. But I can tell you this.
Yes, dear God.
I can tell you this. Whoever you are, Jesus Christ loves you tonight.
Amen.
And what everybody else has failed to do, God can fix it for you. And change you. Before you leave here tonight, God can change you.
Amen.
See, we are a church that believes
what
we say.
Yes, sir.
We believe what we say.
Come on, Pastor.
Yes, amen.
That Jesus took me into a home from rags. I went to nice clothes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Lord.
Good shoes.
Yeah.
Car to drive when I reached my driver's age. All over the world, he's taken my feet. Europe. I preached the gospel in Switzerland. I preached it in Germany. I preached it in Africa, South America.
Oh my! Yes.
Canada.
Dear God. Dear God.
God is a good God.
Come on, that's right. Yes, he's good.
And tonight, instead of being the homeless boy, and my wife knows this to be true, I can get on any plane, go anywhere. Any destination, and there'll be people waiting.
Amen.
For tomorrow. We're glad to see you.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Isn't God good?
Amen. To us. Hallelujah.
He can change your circumstances.
Come on, Pastor.
And he's going to do that for somebody here tonight.
Yes, he is. Come on, Pastor.
Someone is going to surrender their life to
amen.
Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Someone is going to come here and pray. And somebody among this great church we have that God is changing and revamping and remaking, God is going to give this church right here strength from heaven.
Come on, Pastor.
And strength from our
Jesus.
God. I tell you, I felt the Holy Ghost all day long. All day long. Praise the God of Israel. Praise the God of Jacob, Abraham, and Isaac. Praise the God we serve. He is a good God.
Yes.
Would you blow the shofar right now? Amen. Praise God. He is a good God.
Hallelujah.
He can change your life. He can change your life. Amen. I want you to sing that.
Thank you, Lord.
I've been praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We see the preaching of the cross is to those that perish foolishness. Just as the man buying shoes with no legs, it seemed foolish. But to us which are saved, it is the power of God. Jesus said, with God, all things are possible. Nothing is impossible with God. God delights in faith. And that's his economy. He doesn't need money necessarily. He blesses those that use it for his glory and honor. But we're in the house of prayer tonight, in the house of faith. And as Brother Matt Knopf exhorted us so well, we need to find our place in God's extreme power. God holds the key to the future. We don't.
He does.
We think we do sometimes. But
come on, Brother Mike.
God has the key.
Brother God has the key.
And Jesus said, I give you the keys to the kingdom, because they had faith to follow him to the very end. And that's our job tonight in this generation, in this 21st century. God has a cross, but he has a victory for each of us.
He does, amen.
And he has a miracle. He has a wonderful plan for each of us. requires is a grateful heart and faith to believe. So I'd like to be a part of you and just lend to this song tonight. I've never traveled far around the world and never seen the many thrills and sights unfurled, but I have taken the journey of journeys meant for me.
Come on, yes, hallelujah.
To Calvary's mountain.
Think about it.
There
Jesus has touched so many. This is a Holy Ghost service.
Oh God, yes.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God.
You know this is going all over the nation.
Yes, yes, it is.
But all over the world.
Yes.
There's people watching this now.
Yes, sir.
Canada. Over in Ethiopia. This is going all over the whole world.
Yeah.
This church and worship.
Right. Oh God, God, dear God.
Praise your Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise your Lord.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Brother Matt was talking earlier about God showing up on time. I was telling Sister Marlo last night. I have an accountant that does my paperwork for me. I've trusted her for years to do my taxes. So this year I'm thinking, yay, I'm going to get some money back. No, I kept getting letters from the IRS and the IRS from the IRS. So I took all my paperwork. Now they're auditing me. But let me tell you how good God is.
Come on.
I have insurance. I pay for medical insurance, and then I pay for an extra policy just to cover me so if something happens, I'm took care of. I didn't think nothing about it. I filed the claim. All I wanted them to do was pay for my hospital when I went the day before lonely surgery. I had gotten some rust in my eye from taking some boat seats apart. It was late at night. There was no quick cares open or nothing. My only option was to go to the hospital because I had to have him at the hospital 5 o'clock the next morning. So I filed the claim, didn't think a thing about it. Went out yesterday, was going out to give blood, checked the mailbox. I never check the mailbox. I always get beat to the mailbox. There was a letter in there from me, from my insurance company, and I'm thinking, thank you, Jesus. Because I've been praying about this all week. I've been chasing the devil all week. He is just, I've just been running him. I said, he's either running down 14th or he's running down Manatee Avenue because he has been messing with me all week.
All week long.
I opened that letter. Not only did they pay the money I owed the hospital, they gave me a good bundle of it with the work that I have and everything. It'll pay all my bills. And it'll pay what I owe the IRS. And I just want to sit here and not give God the praise for that. Because I am thinking, where am I going to get this money from? It's a good church. You know what I'm saying? Where am I going to get it from? So thank you, God. Doesn't read your mail or check on you and know what's going on in your life. Because He knows what's going on. Even when we don't even know what we're going to do, He's already got it taken care of for you. I just wanted to, I couldn't sit here and not praise Him tonight. He's doing for me in my life.
Well,
and
glory
I just
ask
continuous prayer for my family. As you know, I try to come as much as I can. You guys know I work a lot, more than I need to work.
You need more than you need.
But my husband, he can't hardly do nothing right now. He's still healing, and I have to do what I have to do. But it doesn't change what's in my heart. It doesn't change the love that
no,
I have for God.
Doesn't.
It doesn't change the appreciation I have for what He
not.
Has done for me. When Brother Marlo tells his story about being on the street, I know how he feels. Because at 16 years old, I was on the street.
Tell it.
I left home. I was rebellious as he was.
Tell it.
I didn't want nobody telling me what to do.
Tell it.
And, buddy, I mean, I hit the street and I did not want to go home. That was the last place I wanted to go. But
tell
let
it.
Me tell you something. Over the years, God has took care of me. He has took care of me. And I just want to give Him praise.
Give Him the glory.
Because there is nobody else that has took care of me.
Amen.
My God has took care of me.
Amen.
Glory to God.
My God, I feel like telling everybody to shout.
I need to praise God.
Yes.
As some of you already know, yesterday afternoon, God gave us a new life in our family. We got a brand new great-grandson. He was born at 5:18 our time yesterday afternoon. And we just thank God for him and
yes.
We praise Him for with everything
yes.
We have.
Yes, Brother Dave. Thank
God. Tell him what the name is of your
great-grandson.
His name is Cohen, and that means priest in Hebrew.
Praise God.
Amen.
Many people come when they find their lives changed. I want to recognize tonight, Mother, the Lord bless you. It was a beautiful sight to see you and Jessica here.
Yes, amen.
Not just here, but Jesus touched you, Mother.
Amen.
And you'll never be the same.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I think what a wonderful work God does through people. Jessica's life, as Amber's, and others as well. But it's been affected and changed by Joe and Denise here. They do their work. They do it because He touched them and changed their life. What a wonderful work. And I want to recognize, I just met him tonight, Dean here. I don't have the card near me here, but let me have it. Praise God. Eric, I'll have Brother Eric introduce him because Eric, would you introduce Dean?
I would be glad to. This is Dean Sutherland.
Dean Sutherland. Dean, would you lift your hand over there? God bless you.
God bless you.
This is a place of recovery. This is a place of recovery. Dean Sutherland is a chiropractic doctor. And for 20 years, he came tonight needing the adjustment himself.
Amen.
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 Amen. That's right, brother.
Isn't it wonderful when a master chiropractor can adjust you your whole life? I believe the message you preached tonight, Brother Matthew, was the message for the church.
Amen.
God can change your circumstances.
Yes, He can.
He has.
Yes, He does. Come on.
And I want this man to know it's kind of odd and different, but it makes you know how great God is. This church, it has been 66 years since we had a chiropractic doctor sit in our congregation. But we had one that led our orchestra a few years ago, Dr. Henry Howard. He was from Switzerland. And I visited him when I was in the United States Army there in Switzerland. And he had a wonderful, wonderful congregation of people, as well as being a doctor. He's with the Lord now. But I'm glad to see this doctor.
Amen.
God did a good job.
All the time.
All the time. You see, he brought you here. Dean has appointed recovery and appointed direction, and we're just thankful. Hasn't God been good to us tonight? Now, I don't want the enemy to have one thing on you.
No, sir.
And whatever there is, whatever it is, I want you to lift your hand with me right now.
Come on.
And believe by faith in Jesus Christ.
Come on.
That circumstance will change.
Come on, Pastor.
And that God altar. With hands uplifted, I believe, that the power of the Holy Spirit, the unlimited faith I have in God, that all things are possible. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what it is that I'm asking. Deliverance. Setting free. Changing around. In my life. I believe. This minute. This moment. To the power of Jesus Christ. It is done. It is changed. I am unshackled. And I praise Him. Let's give Him a glory shout. Push everybody right here in these chairs. Not going to be a half-filled band. Praise God. We're going to have band practice. Everybody be here. Amen, amen. Drummer, organist, praise God, everybody. Bless the name of the Lord. Amen, all right? Done deal? Done deal. Praise God. Amen, done deal. All right, look at your neighbor and say, it's a, well, we got a testimony. All right.
Somebody gave my great-granddaughter Jocelyn some clothes and apparently had cat hair on it, and she's allergic to it. And she was in bad shape this morning. And so I walked in there and I just said a simple prayer. I said, Lord, you used me to dissolve kidney stones. You used me to heal cancer. You used me to do different miracles. I said, God, touched her and healed her.
Yes.
4 minutes later, I come out of my room and she was out there on the patio playing.
God bless you real good. Tuesday night is bilingual service. Tomorrow night, Bible study at 6, a great Bible study. Band practice at 7:15. And we will move away and make for the band when they come in. Tuesday night's bilingual. Wednesday night, invite anybody in the county that you can find standing still for 2 minutes. Praise God. Tell them to come to the Revival Center of the church Wednesday night. Amen. Amen. Hey, God bless you. Turn to your neighbor so you never looked as good as you do right now. Praise God.